BOEstrategy.com. Hello, this is Daniel Grady with a quick look at the markets for today, Thursday, April 10th. We have a somewhat busy day coming up starting at 8 o'clock GMT when we have the monthly report from the European Central Bank. This could generate some volatility in the euro and in European stocks. Then at 11 o'clock GMT we have the policy decision from the Bank of England, which could generate some volatility in the pound and of course British stocks. However, no change here is expected. Normally the Bank of England governor will have a press conference after a change in policy to explain it to the markets, and at the moment no press conference is scheduled, so no change here is expected. However, without any change there could still be some volatility. At 12:30 we have new housing price index from Canada, 12:30 GMT. However, that's not expected to generate all that much volatility, at least not as much as what we have at the same time from the United States, which are our weekly employment data. And then at 6 o'clock in the evening, we have the monthly budget statement from the United States, which is also not expected to generate all that much volatility. Moving over to the markets, the S&P 500 continued to move on the upside yesterday, completing its bounce off of the 1,850 level as we expected. This was following the release of the FOMC minutes yesterday, which showed that interest rates are not likely to increase in the United States until after the market was initially expecting or initially feared that they would. This led to a general rally in stocks across the world, including in Asian sessions during early trading. Asian stocks were slightly higher. And also there's a move towards linking the Shanghai and Hong Kong stock exchange in China. Going into the session today, S&P 500 futures are trading just slightly higher. They're less than 0.1% up at the moment, which is showing a general neutral risk appreciation, which would mean investors are likely expecting or waiting for some kind of news to drive the market. And in the meantime, market's going to be trading on technicals. The euro continued to move higher yesterday. It was above 1,38.40, which had been our previous resistance, and it's now turned into support. It's moved a little bit higher above that as it's getting closer to 1,39. This is it's likely to encounter further resistance, so we could be looking at a curve over and move on the downside in the short term. But at the moment we still have support at 1,38.40 and resistance at 1,39. The pound yesterday moved higher, and so far during early trading today has bumped against 168 as we expected. This completes a close to 2.5%, actually a little bit more than 2.5% move over the last 3 days. So some form of short-term correction is to be expected. This is the highest the pound has been against the dollar since early February. So even though overall bias for the pound continues to be on the upside as it moves towards the top of this long-term trend that it's been maintaining, in the short term you might be looking at a correction to pull back towards a relatively soft support level here at 167.50. However, we don't have strong support until 166.80, and then our next level of resistance is at 168.40. The yen continued to gain strength against the dollar. However, the dollar yen pair move on the downside is starting to get a lot shorter, which we have yesterday and during early trading today. We're getting close to an important support level here at 102.30, which is also the bottom of this trend line. And 101.30 is support, and then we have 102.30 as resistance. And then finally we have gold, which tried to get above 1,310 once again, but failed to do so. And so we have support at 1,285. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching and happy trading.